34 Pall Mall is located in the heart of Bendigo, one of the largest inland cities in Australia and the fourth most populated in Victoria. The city was founded after the discovery of gold in 1851, which led to a mass population of the area. By the 1880s, Bendigo was deemed the richest city in the world, which led to the construction of the CBD, including its beautiful and timeless architecture that still remains today. This includes the buildings surrounding our site, such as the Old Colonial Bank, originally built in 1887, the first Myer store in Australia, the Beehive Building, which formerly housed the Bendigo Mining Exchange, the Soldiers Memorial, Alexandra Fountain and the surrounding buildings, and the Old Post Office and Law Courts. The site originally contained the Bendigo Arcade, that sadly burnt down in the 1970s and was replaced with the current building. As I mentioned earlier, the current building has recently been demolished, leaving the site empty and ready to be built on. The site is very narrow and long, being 500 meters squared in area and having a slight slope that runs from the back of the site to the front. At the back left corner of the site is an easement. This space is used for the fire exit of the neighbouring property and cannot be built on. The site offers spectacular views of Roslyn Park and the Bendigo CBD, as well as having good access to Northern Sun. At the top of the site there is a laneway that is shared with the neighbouring property Myer. It is currently used as a loading dock for Myer, but will be redeveloped into the main entrance into the proposed Myer food court at the back. There is also a connecting laneway that runs across the rear of the site. This will connect the Myer laneway with the existing Victoria Lane located on the other side of the Old Colonial Bank. There are many factors and areas that will either restrict, limitate, or influence the outcome of a design. These factors can include location, building and planning regulations, site conditions, financial costs, and many, many more. But for this project, there were four factors that influenced the design more than any others. These were heritage, the site slash location, planning zones and overlays, and sustainability. The proposed building will be three stories in height and contain a cafe, the Indigenous Cultural Heritage Centre, two commercial office spaces, and three residential apartments. The zoning and spatial relationships of the building are shown in the bubble diagram on screen. There were three main areas and themes that inspired the concept design for the proposed building. The first being Bendigo's history and culture. Due to its location, we wanted to pay respect to the heritage aspects of the area, but also draw inspiration from the rich history of Bendigo. This came in the way of the Poppet Head, a structure that at one time would have been seen all across Bendigo and central Victoria, including directly across from our site. The second area of inspiration came from the Indigenous culture and heritage of the area. We wanted to celebrate the local culture of the area and create a platform to showcase it both in the Indigenous Cultural Heritage Centre and the building itself. And the last area of inspiration was sustainability. It was at the forefront of the materials chosen, the systems used, and the general design and form of the building. The bulk of the building is made up of precast concrete panels that are covered in green walls. There is also natural timber cladding, a rusted steel frame, and black aluminium windows. These materials create a beautiful contrast between each other and the buildings surrounding them. The areas of concrete panels that are not covered by green walls will be spaces for street art, and areas that the Indigenous Cultural Heritage Centre will have access to. The form and shape of the building draws inspiration from Bendigo's past, being designed to tell the story of a poppethead that has fallen over and decayed over the years, with nature slowly reclaiming it. At the front, the building has been designed to blend into the background of the heritage buildings in the streetscape. Being set back 2 metres from the site boundary and having similar heights and forms to the neighbouring buildings, as well as using contrasting natural materials, allows the proposed building to have a presence in the streetscape but make the heritage aspects and buildings in the area be prominent and the centrepiece of the street. All entries to the building are off the Maya Laneway. This is to help draw people down the laneway to the cafe and the neighbouring Maya food court. The ground floor is split up into 4 zones, the first being the Indigenous Cultural Heritage Centre located at the front of the building. The centre has a large area to display art and hold exhibitions. At the back there is a small office space and a secure storage facility to house objects that are not on display. As I mentioned before, the centre would have access to the external walls that could be used to display art, advertisement for exhibitions or for street art. At the rear of the building is Zone 2, the cafe. The cafe uses similar materials as the exterior of the building. It has large windows throughout it, allowing it to have a connection with the laneway outside. Natural light cascades through the windows, creating a comfortable and inviting space. There is a large counter and service area, a fully functioning commercial kitchen, and at the back, a storage facility that has delivery access via the connecting laneway. The cafe will also have access to the outdoor seating area located at the front. Zone 3 is located in the centre of the building and is the main access point for the floors above, containing the lobby, lift and stairwell. Zone 4, services, are located at the front, middle and back of the building. These zones continue vertically throughout all 3 floors and allow for easy access and connection for services throughout the building. Level 1 contains 2 office areas, Office 1 at the front and Office 2 at the back. Both are the same size, being roughly 90 meters squared in area. Each has a large open plan office space at the front, with 2 private offices and a conference room located at the back. The use of natural timber, greenery, and light colours creates a comfortable and calming working environment throughout the building. The offices have large north-facing windows that allow light and warmth to enter, and both have large balconies at either end. Office 2 gets the smells and sounds of the Maya food court and the laneways below. Office One looks out over the beautiful views of Roslyn Park and Pall Mall. Located in the centre of the building are the shared amenities for the offices. This includes the kitchen and breakout area for employees to relax in. Back on the ground floor at the rear of the property, there is also a secure bike storage facility for employees to use. There are two residential apartments on level 2. Both are designed to meet the platinum level of the livable housing design guidelines. This means that anyone who has a disability, suffered an injury, or the elderly would be able to comfortably and easily live in the apartment. Apartment 1 is a one-bedroom apartment. It has a large open-plan living area and a modern-style kitchen with a walk-in pantry. The living area opens up to the beautiful north-facing balcony via large windows and sliding doors. The balcony offers spectacular views of Roslyn Park and Pall Mall and is surrounded by the beautiful greenery and natural timber of the building. It is shaded by deciduous vines growing on a pergola that block out the hot summer sun but allow the warm winter sun to enter the balcony and indoors. There is a modern style bathroom, and at the front lies the master bedroom with walk-in robe. Apartment 2 is a two-bedroom apartment with a similar layout as apartment 1. With a big open-plan living area and modern-style kitchen with a walk-in pantry. The master bedroom lies at the rear, with a large walk-in robe, a study nook, and north-facing windows. On the left, there is a modern-style bathroom, and bedroom 2 is located on the right, which also has north-facing windows looking out over the balcony. The balcony is the same as apartment 1, but offers views of Bendigo's rooftops and the laneway below, making it a beautiful space to relax and cook a barbecue on a summer's eve. In the lobby area, there is a bin chute for residents to use. Apartment 3 is located at the back of the property, on the other side of the connecting laneway. It is a small but cosy one-bedroom apartment spread out over 3 levels. You enter into the stairwell on the ground floor. At the back is a storage room that has direct access to the laneway via a roller door. This can be used to store bicycles, outdoor equipment, and general storage, or the space could easily be adapted into a second living area. Going up the stairs to level 1, you find an open plan living area with a modern style kitchen. There is also a small powder room and a European style laundry. Off the living room is a small balcony, shaded via deciduous vines and looking out over the Maya food court. Level 2 contains the master bedroom, With an ensuite and large walk-in robe, the room offers great views of the laneway below and Pall Mall in the distance. There is also a nice-sized study off the bedroom. It has a large sliding door, so the two rooms can be separated. The triangle-shaped windows on level 1 and 2, as well as the windows in the stairwell, allow northern sun to enter the apartment, but more importantly creates a beautiful effect inside the apartment, but also on the exterior, adding to the poppet head theme of the building. For the building to achieve a sustainable footprint, it has utilized the latest in energy reduction and water saving technology, as well as applying the ESD principles. The building will be powered by solar panels located on the roof that will produce enough power to run majority of the building, including the heating and cooling systems. The building will have water tanks located on the roof for rainwater harvesting. This water will be used throughout the building for sinks, toilets and showers. There will also be a grey water system located in the service room at the back of the building. This will treat water from sinks and showers and use it in the toilets and throughout the irrigation system for the green walls on the exterior of the building. The building's hot water will be from solar hot water panels located on the roof. The gardens, vertical green walls and balcony gardens throughout the building will reduce and slow down the amount of stormwater runoff the site will have, as it will be absorbed by the vegetation. The building will have a hydronic radiant heating and cooling system installed in the floors on all three levels, and the unit and storage tank will be located on the roof. Radiant systems on average use 30% less power than conventional systems, and the power used in our system will come from the solar panels on the roof. The building uses natural deciduous greenery for shading, helping limit heat entering the building during summer. The windows in the building will also have blinds hooked up to an automatic system. The building utilizes a night purging system in the office and commercial spaces, helping circulate air and cool the building down. Night purging works by having automatic windows that open at night time when temperatures are dramatically cooler and allows fresh air to circulate through the building. There will also be a separate ventilation system installed in the ceiling with the unit located on the roof. 34 Pall Mall is a building that draws inspiration from the past but creates a bright and sustainable future for the CBD of Bendigo.